In this video, we cover the finalization and customization steps for a PowerProtect data domain system, following the physical racking and initial network configuration of the system. Using your browser, open and log in to the PowerProtect Data Domain System Manager, or DDSM UI. The initial sysadmin password will be your PowerProtect DD system serial number. The System Configuration Wizard should automatically start the first time you log in to DDSM. If it does not, then from the Maintenance menu, click Configure System. The Configure System option uses a wizard-style workflow that takes you through all the required steps and customization options to get your PowerProtect DD up and running. First is licensing. Locate the license file you were provided with your PowerProtect DD system and upload it to the system. As we see here, we have licenses that enable Active Tier, DD Boost, and Replication. Adjusting network settings is optional, but we recommend to review them. During the initial setup, we already set an IP and other settings. Additional network interfaces can be configured. For example, if your environment uses separate backup, management, and replication networks, this is the place to add connectivity to those networks. For our purposes, we just have the one network, so we are going to click Submit. Next, configure the PowerProtect DD file system. DDoS will do a storage pre-check and automatically select the minimum required packs for active tier and minimum required packs for the cache tier. If the system has more than the minimum number of packs, then they will show up in addable storage, and you can add these to the active tier as long as you have the additional capacity licensed. Click Add to Tier and then review your selection to ensure the desired drives were added. In this example, we can just click Next to continue. For the system settings, there are several important values that should be checked and updated as necessary. The sysadmin password should be changed. The administrative email address and SMTP info should be provided, and alerting info should be selected. It is also a good idea to provide the system location or other information to make identification of the system as easy as possible when alerts or status reports are being sent out. Review the changes and click Submit. Depending on your backup software and environment, the next three sections may or may not need to be configured. Typically, however, DD Boost is configured in all situations, as both Dell EMC and third-party backup applications using the PowerProtect DD system will take advantage of DD Boost integration. Boost provides a mechanism that accelerates backups for various clients. Since we have licensed DD Boost, we simply add an existing user and click Next. Third-party software and Dell EMC software products will use this user to communicate with the DD system and to perform backups and other administrative activities. If you are planning to use Windows file shares for backups, the CIFS section is where you create the share by providing a Windows workgroup name, a share name, and a folder on the DD system for the backup data to be stored in. This share can be used as a backup target for Windows networked backups. Similar to CIFS shares, NFS exports can be created on a PowerProtect DD system. In this example, we are creating an NFS export named NFS1 and storing it on the directory path /data/call1/NFS1. After clicking Next, we can confirm that we wish to create the share using the mtree shown. And finally, we're given a quick summary to review before clicking Submit. Once you've completed the NFS step, you could optionally configure VTL if you are licensed for it. In this example, we have not covered configuring VTL. At this point, you've completed the initial system configuration using the PowerProtect Data Domain System and can start sending it backups from your backup clients of choice. For more information about setup and configuration processes for PowerProtect DD, visit support.emc.com.